Hey, welcome back to EDF. You may notice that there's no voices or anything because that shit fucking pissed me off. I went and played through the last three missions of the game so that I could sort of see if I could beat them. That's why I'm using different weapons. I changed up my strategies. But that lady that they said would help me is always annoying the shit out of me. These last three levels, she just made me so angry to listen to. So I just couldn't. I played every level multiple times to try and make sure I could get a strategy that worked. Speaking of which, these royal drones, if you take them out first, if you do them and the Leroys, which I'm about to go and do, then your people don't die. And if your people stay alive, they serve as extremely good distractions for later. So you want them alive. This is one of those special times when I'm recommending not letting your friends get killed. So I figured out, and it probably should have been fairly obvious, it's the kind of game these games are in general, that these last three levels, well, definitely the last level, but the last three levels are basically just fucking use overwhelming force. Just hit them with a shitload of damage straight away and try to collect health when you're running around. That is something that you'd think would be obvious, but it's not how I ever play most of the levels, because I always play as a ranger. Playing as a fencer just seems to be necessary. Ah, fucking shit. There is one problem with not having voices turned on, and that is very specifically that you do not get heads up when things are showing up. I took out pretty much everything that was fighting me over here, so I think maybe this level is going to go my way. I worked out this strategy just so that it would fucking work. Kill the fucking drones, kill the Leroys, get those aliens out the way, then everything else is just monsters, and they're generally easy even if they are fucking roly-polies pissing me off. But it still works. All right, now they got these teleportation anchors. When they get those coming in, the really big one is too tall. It's actually too tall for me to fight anything from. I can't shoot it unless I use the fucking missile launcher that I've got. So I gotta wait on that one. Kite things, take stuff out. If you can take it out fast, while it's like hovering over you, which is generally what I can do. If you can take it out really fast, then they don't respawn fast enough to keep up with you. And thank the lucky stars, there's no fucking teleportation anchor dropping roly-polies, because that would make this the most annoying thing. Roly-polies, if you're just fighting them, roly-polies are not a problem. Roly-polies are an amazing support class, and that shit, they're just so good at it. Like, imagine you're playing, I don't know, it's been so long since I played WoW, I couldn't give you an exact example, which is too frustrating for an analogy here. But imagine you're playing an MMO or you're playing a TTRPG. In either of those cases, you can play as a character who can, like, stun enemies and make it harder for them to do anything to your tank or anything like that. That is what the fucking roly-polies are, and it's the most frustrating shit in the world when you're the one trying to hit the fucking tank. Why do most of my analogies end up with me being the bad guy in the scenario? I don't know why I do that to myself. This mission takes a bit of time. Since I didn't want to deal with that, I decided to play through it a couple times, get the strategy down, and make sure I knew what I was doing. I'm very glad I didn't die on this mission, but I'm almost done with it, and then the next mission is an insane bitch. Oh, damn it. Okay, yeah, this mission is a bitch of a mission, but I'm not using the weapons that I practiced with. Well, that sucks. This motherfucker looked right at me for like 5 seconds and didn't do shit. Another big thing that I didn't like having the voices on for is not just that they're all like way too damn dark and annoying. It's also that they talked so constantly. So constantly. I didn't have the noise of me running out of shotgun ammo. I hear my shotgun when I'm firing it constantly. And when I hear that noise, it tells me that I'm still capable of firing. And in levels like this where you go blind, if you cannot hear yourself run out of ammo, you're fucked. All right, space laser is down. Now's up for the next stage of the mission. This is the part of the mission that fucking sucks. It turns into a thing where it's protected by a bunch of floating platforms, but all of those damn platforms, they're out of range. So I gotta wait for them to be in range, and they move in like an orbital pattern. But that orbital pattern shifts constantly. Fucking hate it. I absolutely should have practiced with this fucking weapon setup before I came, because the last ones, I know the missiles didn't travel fast enough to catch up to these platforms. These, I don't know if they're moving faster or slower than the high altitude launcher. All right, one shield down. That's fucking annoying though, because it just means that now there's more very annoying weapons shooting at me that blow me up. And it's not so much about damage. I very rarely have to worry too much about the amount of damage that these fucking things are doing to me. It's basically just things stunning and knocking me down, that kind of shit. Okay. I don't know how it happened, but I lost a shitload of fucking health and got knocked down a bit there. I fucking almost died. That would have really sucked. This sucks losing it for the same reason as the last level. It isn't that it's hard to get back to this point. It's not hard. This shit I would have lost there because of complete carelessness and nothing else. It's just how long it fucking takes. This is a slog. All right, shields down. So now I can just target this fucking thing directly. It's annoying as hell, but if I can get the damage done, oh, fucking prick. The easiest way to beat this level is to just be a goddamn ranger. Get a fucking sniper rifle that shoots across the entire planet, and then nothing matters, because any of those are also anti-materiel rifles, and that shit will just fucking destroy everything. Got you, you fucking asshole. And you don't have to kill everything. The win condition is just destroy the fucking mothership. And you got this long thing because the lady that's supposed to be helpful but isn't really talks about is that god, because there's just a thing floating there in the air. And then you have to go and fight the fucking thing. And that's the final mission, is to fight God. And I know that in general, when I play these, I have been doing two levels at a time, and that I'm doing a third level right now seems ridiculous. But this mission, I played it, like I said, I played it to try and get a strategy to it on hard mode. And the strategy is to pump him so full of shotgun shells that he just can't survive. And it works incredibly fucking fast. See, he's already summoning his fucking aliens. If you can, I know strategy, like I just said, is basically at this point for me just pumping him full of shotgun shells. If you can, knocking his legs off will stun him. Doing a shitload of damage doesn't necessarily stun him directly, but ripping his legs off, ripping his arms off, that does. And his legs are a lot easier to rip off than his arms. I pretty much just started this mission. I think I've only been shooting at him for about a minute or so, and he's already summoned his second group of alien bodyguards. So, yeah. It's good to have some long-range missile launchers, though. Coward runs away a lot. He rears up and tackles people, and when he does that shit, you can't hit him with a shotgun real easy, because he's staying as far away from you as he can get, just so you don't have the close range. So, some missile launchers really fucking help. There we go. He's got his heavily armored ones now. No flamethrowers. I don't really get that. The most effective fucking heavily armored alien in this entire game. It is the most effective. I'm very confused as to why his personal bodyguard, why his personal retinue doesn't have the most effective damage dealer in his entire army. There, he's dead. This is the longest recording of an EDF5 video that I've done, but this is also the shortest fucking level I've played as well. It takes practically no time with... If you're using Inferno level weapons on a hard level boss, of course it's not going to take all that long. That's just it. And then there's a final cutscene that says they all left because they were scared of us. The Nameless had died, which is just another way of saying God, so it's another ridiculous point. But I love this game. It's fucking great. I just never played through it with a fencer before. So I was happy that I got that. I was hoping that you would enjoy it. I hope you did, and I hope you come back for what I do next. I'll see y'all later. Bye.